So as you know, KEYNOTE-355 is a randomized placebo-controlled phase 3 study of pembrolizumab plus chemotherapy versus placebo plus chemotherapy in patients with not treated locally recurrent or metastatic triple-negative breast cancer. Okay, so the data with checkpoint inhibitors in triple-negative breast cancer are interesting. There are some important data with pembrolizumab single agent showing that there is some efficacy. However, preliminary data showed that chemotherapy plus pembrolizumab seems to improve outcomes. This is why this randomized study was designed. In brief, chemotherapy and chemotherapy included different usually drugs in the clinic, paclitaxel or nab-paclitaxel or carbogem, plus pembrolizumab, a PD-1 inhibitor, or same chemotherapy plus placebo. Again, this was a randomized phase 3 study. It was a pivotal study. The primary endpoints, including progression-free survival and overall survival in patients with PD-L1 positive tumors. And PD-L1 positive tumors were considered in two ways. One of them, with a PD-L1 CPS score, is a way of measuring PD-L1 status, doesn't matter, of 10 or more, or 1 or more, and the same for survival. So the primary endpoint was clearly met. The hazard ratio was 0.65. Median PFS, median progression-free survival, moved from 5.6 months to 9.7 months in favor of patients who received chemotherapy and pembrolizumab. For all patients with PD-L1 CPS more or equal to 10. It was a clear signal also for patients with CPS more or equal to 1, but this did not reach statistical significance. That's why pembrolizumab improved progression-free survival significantly from a clinical and mathematical perspective in PD-L1 10 or more triple-negative breast cancer patients in the first-line setting. Toxicity was, as expected, no more toxicity in chemo plus pembro compared to chemo. And of course, it's normal to highlight that there were a significant higher of number of patients with some immune-related toxicity, basically hypo or hyperthyroidism. So the trial met the primary endpoint, and pembrolizumab could be considered a new standard of care or a new good option for this group of patients. Remember that there was another important study, which is the IMPASSION 130. In IMPASSION 130, it was a very similar trial design, first-line triple-negative breast cancer, one of the chemotherapeutic agents, nab-paclitaxel, with or without placebo, or atezolizumab, which is a PD-L1 inhibitor by Roche. In this study, the PD-L1 was measured by another assay. It was by Ventana, and the antibody was SP142, another assay, another antibody. In about 40% of patients did have positivity for PD-L1 status, one or more. And the trial was positive, clearly, for this group of patients. In our study, in KEYNOTE-355, another assay, DACO, and another antibody, 22C3, was used. In this case, the clinical study was clearly positive for patients with PD-L1 CPS 10 or more, which is more or less to 38-40% of all patients. So going back to your question, I think that we have, or we need, a CPS score of 10 or more for this drug to be used, in my opinion. Remember that there is another important study in the neoadjuvant study, in the neoadjuvant setting, presented by Peter Smith last year at ESMO. It was a very similar idea, chemo pembro or chemo alone in the neoadjuvant setting, also with very positive data. So I think that we have now two randomized phase 3 studies showing that pembrolizumab adds activity to chemotherapy in the neoadjuvant setting, as ESMO last year, in the metastatic disease first line ASCO this year.